Hi, friends. So welcome to another art experience by me. So you've heard the great Diana Ross starting us off. I think she's amazing. And I was actually listening to her music as I drew this. So I figured a song by her in the beginning would be appropriate. So this is more or less how I drew this. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Well, it's a pot, you know. Actually, there's several flower pots that my mom has that have this flower, and I wasn't really sure what it was called. My sister gave her the original plant. We just sort of knew it as the heart plant, but anyhow, yeah. So here, if you would be so kind, please like this video, subscribe, maybe make a comment, and share so that it can help. It helps me build the channel. And then also, doesn't cost you a thing. It's just really brief. Click that like button, click the subscribe button. And if you can, leave me a comment. Comment can be a happy face. It could be any emoji as well, and it totally helps me a lot. Now back to this drawing. So I had a kind of, you know, I mean, how hard could it be to draw a bunch of hearts, right? Some green ones, some red ones, but it's actually harder than you think. So trying to figure out like what stem goes in front of what, or if the flower or the leaf goes in front of the stem. Yeah, it was a little hard, but well worth it. Let's listen to some more of Miss Diana Ross. Stay tuned for final results. They're amazing. So welcome back. I hope you enjoy that other additional song. I've always loved that song. I remember hearing it in the movie, like, I think, what was it called? Oh, Made in Manhattan. Jennifer Lopez played a maid. anyways, but I remember when they sang that song, and I thought it was really cool, so I bought that song at that time, and I figured out why not use it here. So, like I said, I was listening to Diana Ross, and when I was painting, and I figured I'd give you a little taste of that. Now, please note that I'm using a darker green here. My sister did comment that the green that I used for the sunflower was, or the greens, because I use multiple greens, was not dark enough. She felt like I needed to use more like an olive green, and I agree. I do. It's a bit dark and gloomy and such, but I guess I have to be closer to the actual thing. So this time I'm using a little darker, the green. So like, the flamingo plant ranges in terms of the color of the actual flowers as well as the color of the leaves. Now, the pots of the flamingo plant that I have in my house, their leaves are super dark. Whereas the leaves at my mom's, the leaves are like more like a lime green. And then the flowers in my mom's are darker red, whereas the ones that I have are lighter red. I actually also have like a coral / pink flower one, which lost the blooms. Otherwise, I would have taken a picture of it. But most recently, I forgot to water the plant. So the bloom died, but the plant's still alive. So I'm hoping that the bloom will come back eventually. Because it's really pretty, but the leaves are super dark. So that's why I decided to go with this darker green. I think it's called sap green with a bit of, is it hooker's green? Something like that. But it's like a super dark green. Seems a bit gloomy and such, but it's okay. So I decided to use that. Now, like my leaves are that green, but they're shiny, right? And I couldn't get the shiny part, because for that I would need to use like white in different places and figure out where the light is hitting the plants and stuff like that, and that's just too complicated for me. So I'm gonna just, you know, do what I can. I think I did fairly well. Now, you will also note that I use this canvas just on the wall. I didn't stretch it, which worked, but not as well as obviously a stretch canvas. So, yeah, future, definitely stretch canvas. Here's some more of Diana Ross. I need love,
take a hurry, love. No, you just have to wait. don't come easy, but I keep on.